rates due date. Center focus. First impressions of Roderick. He stood at 5'2", he weighed 113 pounds, and if you were to talk to him, all he talked about was sports, sports, sports. This child's household was solid, which keeps him very grounded. A big part of his life was his father. His father made sure that everything was in line, even with his discipline. Discipline was very, very important with Roderick. He got off task. So with that, we had behavior problems. So with that, when you were to see him and you were to correct him, he would greet you with a warm smile. So how could you ever be upset with a face like that? With Roderick, he has a lot of interests. For one, with sports, he wanted to become a very professional football player. So he wanted to be in the NFL. He had a lot of skills in playing football, but he also had a lot of skills as average kids would do, like playing outside, playing video games, and with that, as an average kid, his favorite games were like Grand Theft Auto and Minecraft, which a lot of kids play during their free time at school. He enjoyed listening to the latest music, more of the R&B and the hip hop, and with those unique things, he also had a talent, which is breeding pit bulls, which is very rare. So with that, I think with all those activities and his dad being a big part of his life, it helped him build his character. So I put things that relate to Roderick. So who likes to read? Roderick struggled in reading, but we encouraged him to do the right thing. Roderick was a second grade reader, and he was still in the sixth grade, which is something that he really, really struggled with. But with that, we were able to put creative things together to help him. We put him in groups where his peers really didn't judge the fact that he couldn't read as well as others. But we also had paraprofessionals in line that also helped drive these things to help him want to engage in learning. Roderick was also recognized with this struggle that he had back in 2014. So he was admitted to special education at that moment. And from there, paraprofessionals and teachers were all hands on deck with providing confidence that he needed to gain to complete the materials that he needed in order to succeed into the next grade. Being on your best behavior. Behavior was a big issue with Roderick. Roderick couldn't focus when it was something that was not interesting to him. So in classes such as reading and math, Roderick was more introverted as a student. Science and social studies, Roderick was very less attentive, simply because the information given to him was less interesting. But for the most part, you know, as an average sixth grader, they loved PE and lunch. That's when they had an opportunity to engage with other peers that they interacted with on a daily basis. Classes in session, I was able to observe Roderick. And one of the areas where he had an issue with, which was science and social studies. And Roderick was accused of taking something that didn't belong to him. And in this instant, with the other student having to raise his voice, Roderick was the center focus. And with that, Roderick didn't listen to his teacher. He was very disruptive, and he talked back. So with those things, as a teacher, you have to sit those type of students that aren't very attentive towards the front. And I felt like if you were able to put him in a situation or in a group where he's able to learn more and interact with people that don't keep him distracted, he's able to obtain the information that you're trying to give, but also teach these students on different levels so they are able to gain the information that you are teaching. One step at a time. We took an interest survey of Roderick, and here he pointed out a few of his classmates who he desired a friendship with. As I noticed, Roderick geared towards people that shared the same interests, like sports or people that had the latest shoes, because I noticed Roderick would swap shoes with different people, which is weird, but when you're into different shoes, it strikes your interest. The ones that he didn't, the ones he didn't draw to, were people that were quiet, people that were smart. But he drew closer to the ones that were making jokes, wasn't paying attention. But although all these students in his classroom, he was often drawn towards the negative group. Although he knew the difference between the good students and the bad students, I felt like he wanted to be more of the in crowd, not so much on the academic side where he should be doing things that are right. But he often fed off of negative energy, which he shouldn't focus on at this moment. But as students grow, they learn to decipher what's good and what's bad. Effective interventions. So when I was able to teach them math and science, I was able to sit Roderick in cooperative learning groups where I would team him up with someone of a higher learning spectrum than he was. And I felt like doing that in a smaller group, he was able to gain the material that he wasn't unsure about, and he was able to learn from someone in the class rather than myself, and feed off of, share different ideas. They were able to reteach something to him that wasn't clear, but also they were able to learn. The higher order student was able to learn the material because they have to be able to reiterate the information that I provided to the whole class to the student that struggled in a certain area. I felt like both of them feeding off of each other made a great difference. And with the assessments, the student was able to read aloud, was given material, but it was also read aloud, the material. So whatever he didn't understand, I was able to clearly define whatever the information was to better assist with whatever information that we learned during math and science. After those 3 days of consecutive math and science in small group and one-on-one interventions with Roderick, I felt like the first day didn't go so well because I didn't have enough information to give students, especially the smaller group students like Roderick, because I didn't know what direction to actually provide them with learning the circumference of a circle and the phases of the moon. But during the next 2 days that I covered, I was able to implement this information by providing more hands-on, more examples, providing an anchor chart. With this, students were able to recognize the things that were unclear to them, and I provided more explicit instruction, where with the 8 phases of the moon, I was able to show a video. Even with the video, I provided assessments where they can go back and reflect with the information that we were going over to better understand the material that was being covered. Because I care, this strategy of the intervention, which was the cooperative learning with Roderick. Like I said before, I provided Roderick with a student with higher learning achievement skills with Roderick. With that, he was able to gain information that he didn't already know, because with him, like I said before, he was a second grade, on a second grade reading level, which he wasn't able to read the sixth grade material or write the sixth grade, write in a sixth grade manner. So with that, some of the assessments was giving the stuff to him orally. If you were able to provide me the information back, then with that, I was able to understand if he gained the knowledge for the information that I was giving him. But most of all, this strategy with pairing him with a higher order student and himself, he was able to learn and he was able to gain a deeper understanding of the topic being explained from that student. That student was able to give the information that I provided to them, and they were able to translate it to him, where they could show him, even show through the models that I provided for the class, and even through the assessment, we can go back and relearn the information that I was given. For example, the activities for group discussion, presentations that I provided, videos, manipulatives, I gave all those different strategies, so the student was able to gain more knowledge of the information that I provided the students. The main character is Roderick. The main focus was patient. Roderick was a handful. From the moment we sat down to complete an assignment, it was a lot of information. He shut us down. He didn't want to do it. So with that, I had to reposition myself and get a different approach. I mean, with him, it's all about the material. And if it was too complicated, he just didn't want to do it. So as a teacher, I found out me reading the material aloud to him, it gave him a different outlook. He was able to hear it and be able to visualize what I was speaking of. Even with the assignments of the eight phases of the moon, I gave them homework assignments where they were to go out and jot down what they saw that night, each day. And I explained to them how the phases of the moon occurred. With that, providing them that visual and even the hearing, he was able to gain more understanding of the information. So as time progressed, he warmed up and he took it easier on me, and it was less and less pushback when it came to understanding the material. He was able to give me more feedback. So with this approach, I felt like I achieved something. So with any student, I feel like patience is the key. You have to understand the student in order to give them what they need. This ends my PowerPoint presentation. As a future educator, I feel like the different strategies for these different students that need that extra attention really helped me gain an understanding of every child is unique. Every child needs that attention. Every child has an ability and they can succeed. So with this, I'm more aware, and it's almost like an eye-opener, that all students can succeed in whatever they do. But as a teacher, we have to push them.